Yes, so today we are going to have discussion. Okay. From level 1, overall I have given 69 questions in parts. Most of the homework was given in previous classes only. So let's start the discussion. First of all, from question number 1 to question number 5, any doubt? You can speak and ask your doubt here only. Do not type, just ask. Speak and ask your doubt. Question 1 to question number 5.
Sir, can you explain question 3?
Question number 3.
Yes, sir.
You have to find the roots. Okay. So x to the power 4 minus 8x squared. Which one?
Also question 5, actually.
5, all right. So first let us discuss question number 3. See, it is biquadratic equation, degree is 4. So it will have 4 roots. And it is easy to solve. We can just change it in quadratic equation by this substitution. So if x square is y, y to the power 2, because x power 4 will become y square only. This is 8y minus 9. We'll make the factors. So y comes out to be 9 and minus 1. But we have to find x. So this means x square is 9. Or x square is minus 1. From the first case or the first answer, we will get two roots, 3 and minus 3. And obviously, for the second one, we will get non-real values because the square is coming negative, so no problem. Because I have already told you about iota, so x square is minus 1. So when we take the square root, we write plus minus and root of minus 1. What is this value? Root of minus 1 is nothing but iota, and this is plus minus 3. So overall, 4 roots are there. And B will be the option, because in B option they have given roots like this. Okay, so just by
excuse me, sir.
Yes,
okay, sir.
Sir, can you please show question number 5?
Okay, I will solve after this. I have not solved it, I will be solving after this. So, question number 3, is it clear?
Yes, sir, question 9 and 10 also my doubt.
Sir, question 5 was in test, right?
Yeah, most of the questions in the test were from this section only. In fact, all the questions were from this level 1 only. Okay, so question number 5. First, we are discussing only from 1 to 5. Okay, so question number 5 is, here also we have to find the roots. Once again, it is based on the equation reducible to quadratic. This can be written as 3 to the power minus x can be written as 1 upon 3 to the power x. Okay, then by substitution, let us assume 3 to the power x is y. So the equation will become y plus 1 upon y equals 10 by 3. Then we will do the simplification. We will ultimately change it in quadratic equation after doing simplification. Cross multiply by 3 and this by y, okay, doing cross multiplication. After that, shifting it here and then making the standard form of quadratic. Now we'll solve quadratic first, we'll get values of y, we'll put it here and get values of x, okay. So the factors are these. And the values or the roots or the values of y will come out to be 3 and 1 by 3, okay. But we have to find x, so we'll put here, put these values here, okay. So 3 to the power x is 3, 3 to the power x is 1 by 3. So from the first part by comparison, we'll get x1 and from the second one, we'll get minus 1. Why? 3 to the power minus 1 is 1 by 3 only. So what are the two roots? Two roots are 1 and minus 1, okay. Option putting is something which is not the part of discussion that anyone can do. There's nothing to learn about it. So these were the questions from question number 1 to 5. Okay, now from question number 6 to question number 10.
So, 9th one.
9th.
6th also.
6th.
So, 8th.
8th.
So, I had a doubt in the 7th one.
Okay, we'll solve them, no problem. Okay, let's start with the 6th question. See, in 6th question, fx is some polynomial 2 and 3 are the roots values of mn. See, this was very easy question. Why you could not pick up? Because it is a straightforward question. You have to simply put the values of x and put these expressions equal to 0. Such questions we even solved in class 10th also. Like zeros are given, find mn and something like this. 2 and 3 are the roots. Okay. So if 2 is the root of this expression, if 2 is the 0 of this polynomial basically, then what will happen? If 2 is the 0, you will put 2 in place of x. And since it is the 0 or the root of this equation, therefore after putting x equal to 2, this whole expression must be 0. This is the definition of the root. So what will happen? This will become 16 plus 4 times of n minus 26 plus n. So this equation finally terms 4m plus n minus 10, this will reduce to 10 and we'll shift it to the right hand side. Okay, so this is the first equation by putting 2. Similarly, put 3 and again put it equal to 0. You will get 2 equations in mn and you can solve them. Okay, similarly, because 3 is also the root of this equation. So this is 54, this is 9 times of m minus 39 plus n equals 0. This is 9m plus n, here it will remain 15. On shifting it to the right hand side, this will become minus 15. So you have these two equations in m and n. You will just solve them. They are linear equation, two variable, and you will get values of m and n from here. Okay, for that you can subtract. This will be 5m, it will be remaining here, it's minus 25 here. M comes out to be minus 5. Put this value of m in any one of the equations. So like if I put it in the first equation, minus 45 so plus 45, n will come out to be 30. These are the two values, m as minus 5 and n as 30. So B will be the option. Please done. Simple definition. What is root? Root is something which when substituted in place of the variable will make the whole expression zero or satisfies this equation. It is already written. Root of the equation fx equals 0. Okay.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, solving the exercise, no? The homework.
Sorry, can you repeat?
Sir, solving the homework, no?
Yes.
Okay, sir.
Yes. This was 6th question. Just wait. All right, let's solve the next question. Question number 7. Number of roots of the quadratic equation. So this is quadratic equation in sec theta. So no problem. It is like solving a quadratic equation only. If you want, you can put it equal to some variable, say y. So this will be 8y square minus 6y plus 1 equals 0. You can solve this equation. Minus 4y minus 2y plus 1. 4y common. This is 2y minus 1. minus 1, 2y minus 1. So because of this, we'll get two values of y, that is half and 1 by 4. So sec theta is half, sec theta is 4, sorry, 1 by 4. So this implies cos theta is 2, you know. Cos is reciprocal of sec. Cos theta is 1 by sec theta. Similarly, cos theta is 4. Now,
right. So,
yes.
So this class is only for the homework questions, no?
I hope so, because there are so many questions. So it is possible that whole class will be used up. Maybe possible. And if the discussion completes earlier, then I will teach. So that depends on the number of doubts. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So cos theta equals 2 and cos theta is equal to 4. And they are asking about the number of roots. So by number of roots, they mean value of theta. That how many values of theta are there such that the number of roots of equation are there. So answer is D, 0. Can anyone explain the reason why the number of roots are 0?
So because cos is value is from minus 1 to 1.
Yes, good. Because I hope you have studied about this thing, that the maximum value of cos theta can be. What can be the maximum value of cos theta?
1,
yes, 1. So maximum value is 1 and minimum value is minus 1. In fact, cos theta can vary from minus 1 to 1. So there can be no angle theta for which cos becomes 2 or 4. Okay. So there are no values of theta. That's why number of roots are 0. This is the explanation.
Sir?
Yes?
Can you please repeat why cos theta cannot be equal to 2 or 4?
See, cos theta, this trigonometric ratio, its highest value can be 1. Have you studied this thing anywhere in physics? That the maximum value of cos is 1 and minimum value is minus 1?
Yes, sir. Okay.
So that is the reason. Actually, you have studied in physics. In maths, I'll be teaching you after this chapter, we'll start with trigonometry. So there I will tell you why cos cannot be greater than 1 and less than minus 1. Okay. So for now, we will refer to physics actually, where you have already learned basic mathematics required for solving class 11 physics. So some trigonometry is taught to you, right? So because of that, we can give the explanation from there. That cos cannot be greater than 1. And they are saying that cos is equal to 2 or 4. So this is not possible. So number of roots will be 0. Okay. Now we'll take question number 8. Question number 8, there is one quadratic equation, a plus 2b plus c equals 0. Okay. Sorry, x square plus twice of a plus bx plus a plus 2b plus c equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation. It has imaginary roots. It is given in the question. It has imaginary roots. And on the basis of this information, you have to predict the nature of this equation. You have to predict the nature of this equation, that what type of roots this equation has. Can anyone tell me how you will use this information that this equation has imaginary roots? What is the concept that you will use here?
The quadratic formula.
Why you will use quadratic formula? It is given that roots are imaginary. So what is the purpose of using quadratic formula? How to use this thing that roots are imaginary?
So after finding... should be less than 0.
Discriminant less than 0. Use this thing. No need to find the roots. You have to use the condition for the nature of roots. Roots are imaginary, d less than 0. apply this in the first equation. So b square, in place of b, we have twice of a plus b. Twice of a plus b is acting as b. So its square will be 4 times a plus b whole square. Minus 4ac, minus 4ac. In place of c, we have this expression. This is less than 0. This is what is given. Okay. Now we'll solve this. So a plus b whole square and multiply by 4 will become 4a square, 4b square. Twice ab into 4 will be 8ab. Minus 4a square, minus 8ab, minus 4ac less than 0. Okay. So I think these two terms will cancel each other. This comes out to be 4b square minus 4ac less than 0. So we have got this result because of the given condition. Okay. Now there is another quadratic equation whose nature of roots we have to discuss. So obviously here also we need to find its discriminant. So if we find its discriminant, it will be 4b square minus 4ac. This is discriminant of the second equation, and I think we have got the answer. You know why? Because this expression 4b square minus 4ac, this is what we have got as a result because of the first equation. What we are getting? We are getting that 4b square minus 4ac is negative, and 4b square minus 4ac is the discriminant of the second equation. That means d is negative because of this, okay? Because of the given information. So as d is negative, therefore roots of this equation are imaginary or non-real or complex, whatever you use. Now according to the option, d will be the answer, okay? Complex numbers, non-real numbers, imaginary numbers, all are same. Simple explanation, just on the basis of sign of discriminant, you can give the answer. This was your question number 8.
Okay, sir. Got it.
Oh, all right.
Now we'll see question number 9. In question number 9, what is given? Given a and b are odd integers. Okay, a and b are odd integers. And then you have to predict the nature of roots of the equation.
So?
Yes.
So for the 8th one, what will be the correct option? It will be complex or?
Obviously, because all the other options are real numbers.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
So obviously D, because imaginary, non-real or complex, all are same. Okay. All have same meaning. Now let us discuss question number 9. It is given that A and B are odd integers. Okay. And we have a quadratic equation because a is not equal to 0. So it's confirmed that it is a quadratic equation. Okay. Just this information. And we have to find the nature of roots of this equation. So rational, irrational, non-real, equal. So once again, discriminant will be used. So to find the discriminant, we'll use the formula b square minus 4ac. This is the formula for discriminant. Let us solve this. So this is 4a square plus b square and 4ab minus 8ab. If we simplify this, this will become 4a square plus b square minus 4ab. And this will also become 2a minus b whole square. By these three terms, using completing the square. Or you can look here only. This is like x square plus y square minus 2xy. So it is x minus y whole square. Now listen very carefully. Since a and b are odd integers, okay, and have a look at the options also. Rational, irrational, non-real, equal. First of all, C option cannot be the answer. Why non-real cannot be the answer? Because discriminant is a square. So it cannot be negative. So roots cannot be non-real. So C cannot be the answer. Now D option, equal. Can anyone tell me why D cannot be the answer? Because in option D it is given equal. So can anyone tell me why D will D cannot be the answer? Because for option D, that is for roots to be equal, discriminant must be zero. And if you will make the discriminant zero, that means 2a minus b is equal to zero. That means 2a is equal to b should be the condition. And this cannot be possible. Why? Because a is odd integer. It is given the question. If a is odd integer, 2a will be even. 2a is even and b is odd. Why 2a is even? Because 2 into something is always even. And something is odd, integer. So 2 into odd integer will be even while b is odd. So if 2a cannot be equal to b, this thing cannot be equal to 0. So discriminant cannot be 0, roots cannot be equal. D option is also eliminated. Now we are left with two options, rational and irrational. If you have understood the theory well, you can very easily tell that a will be the option. Answer will be rational. Who can explain? Who can explain why rational will be the answer? What is the concept related to this question? Any one of you?
So it can be written in the form P upon Q.
No. See, roots, we are not actually finding the roots. But without finding the roots, how we observe their nature? I am asking about that thing. What was the theory?
So root of 2a minus b is the whole square is 2a minus. So it's a perfect square.
Right, right. So I told you that in quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, if the coefficients are rational and discriminant is a perfect square, then roots will be rational. So here the coefficients are 2a, 2a plus b and b. These three are the coefficients, okay? 2a, 2a plus b and b. Since a and b are integers, so obviously these three are integers only. And integers are rational numbers also. Like 5, 5 can be written as 5 upon 1. Minus 2, minus 2 can be written as minus 2 upon 1. Since these coefficients are integers, as a and b are integers, therefore obviously they are rational number also. And now discriminant is a perfect square. So that's why, because a and b are integers, so overall there will be some integer value. 2a minus b will become some integer and it's a square. So definitely it is a square of some number. So it is a perfect square. This is sufficient to tell that roots are rational. Okay. Theory should be very clear. Otherwise you will not be able to pick up the concept used in the question if you don't know what are the points that we have studied. Okay.
Okay, sir.
All right.
Okay, sir.
See, question number 10 is also similar. Question number 10 is also similar. They are asking if the roots of the equation are rational, then what is k? So what you will do? Find the discriminant and check for which given values of k, discriminant is becoming a perfect square.
1 and 2.
Yes, so we can check them. Let us find the discriminant. B square minus 4ac. This becomes 49 minus 24k. So now there can be many values of k for which this may become a perfect square. So that is why we'll have to look at the options now. All these are values of k, so I need not to write k equals every time. Okay, these are the options. So D will be the answer. Why? These are values of k. It is given that then k is equal to. So why 1 and 2? Because if we put k equal to 1 here, okay, if we put k equals 1, D will be 25. 25 is a perfect square. If I put 2, it will become 48. Overall, it will be 1. 1 is a perfect square. So for k is equal to 1 and 2, discriminant is becoming perfect square, roots are rational. Same question 9 and 10. What about other options? They'll be rejected. Why? If you put minus 1 here, in place of k, if you put minus 1, so number will become 49 plus 24. Minus into minus is plus, right? So this will become 73. Obviously, it is not a perfect square. So since minus 1 is not satisfying, so obviously these two will be rejected because minus 1 is present in B option also. Now, similarly, if you will put minus 2, you will get 97. That is also not a perfect square. Option is D. For 1 and 2, this discriminant becomes a perfect square. So, roots will be rational. Same question. 9 and 10. Okay, from 11 to 15,
so 12.
What is given? Roots are not real, D less than 0. Okay, x square minus x plus m equal to 0. For what values of m? The roots are not real. Not real means D less than 0. All these are based on signs of discriminant, nature of roots. So b square minus 4ac less than 0. Now this is simple linear inequality that we have discussed. In fact, we have learned to solve all type of inequalities. This is linear inequality, which we already discussed in while going through the chapter linear inequalities of NCERT. In fact, we have learned to solve every type of inequality because of Weber method. But this is a simple one. Multiply both sides by minus 1, sign will change. Because of this, m is greater than 1 by 4. So how to write this in interval? 1 by 4 to infinity. Yeah, one more thing. There is another notation here. This can be written like this also. Because you may be seeing some type of brackets which you are not using earlier, right? This thing. Both are same. Both are same. So if like these brackets are actually opening just the opposite way, okay? If these brackets are opening just the opposite way, because you are using them like this, okay? Close bracket, close open, open close. But here you might have seen that their opening side is different, right? Other than the usual one. Why? Because it is used for representing open interval only. It is another notation. Just another way of writing this thing. Okay. So that is why A will be the answer. So simply not real means D less than 0 forward.
So what you were saying, the other symbol for open bracket is?
It is already written there. Both are same. Both are same. Either you use this type of bracket or you use these brackets. Both have same meaning. This only. Because if we use these brackets, then same thing comes in close interval. That means values are included. But here value is not included. It is an open interval. So what we write like this, they are using this notation. It is an older notation. Nobody uses it these days. Okay, we use these intervals only. But if like they have given, then A will be the answer. You will not say that D is the answer. Okay, so that may be the confusion. I mentioned both are same. Okay, some things we understand with the help of questions also. It is not necessary that everything will be covered in theory. Some things are observed. Okay, through questions only, and then we build the concepts because of them, and like collecting all the topics, theory part, practice, then discussion, then we are able to perform well in tests. Okay, so make your concepts, and whenever you think something new is there, you add it in your notes or wherever you feel like. Okay, so this was question number 12.
So can you do the 13th one, please?
Which one?
13th.
13th. Right. Okay. Okay, question number 13. Roots of the equation are, and again they are asking us to write the nature. Okay. A plus B minus C. X square minus 2A X plus A minus B plus C equal to 0. They have already mentioned that ABC belongs to Q. Okay, ABC belongs to Q means ABC are rational numbers. See, there are some standard alphabets which are used to represent the sets, like capital N. Capital N means natural number. W means whole number. Z means integer. R means real number. Q means rational number. Okay, so these are certain notations which we study in set theory. In fact, this notation also, this interval notation also, this is also there. But whatever is required, that I have already taught you. Okay. So in this particular question, they have given that ABC are rational numbers. Q stands for set of rational numbers. And we know what are rational numbers, right? So ABC are rational number. We have this equation. They are asking us to find the nature of the roots. Okay. So usually what we do, we find the discriminant, okay? We find the discriminant, and after finding the discriminant, we check its sign or something like that to determine whether roots are non-real or real and equivalent, something like that. So that may be one of the methods, but I want one of you, any one of you who can tell me, can anyone tell me that what is one root of this equation, just by observation? One root is?
One.
Good. So, by observation, one root is one. Actually, I have told you something about this observation thing. If you are not able to observe, at least you can add the coefficients. What are the coefficients? A plus B minus 2C. Next coefficient is minus 2A. Third one is A minus B plus C. Add all of them. If you will add all of them, this will be cancelled. B and minus B will cancel. Sorry, it was minus C only, right? So minus C only. And minus C and plus C will cancel. So overall, their addition is 0. And I told you something. I told you that if the sum of coefficients of a quadratic equation is 0, then its one root is 1. This we have already discussed. Okay. So we have got one root. Now let other root is beta. Other root is beta, and let me apply product of roots. So alpha is 1, because one root is 1, other is beta. So alpha into beta is C upon A. C upon A. This. So beta comes out to be A minus B plus C upon A plus B minus C. Now listen carefully. A, B, C are rational numbers. Okay. So difference of two rational numbers, A minus B, will be a rational number. Then if you add a rational number to another rational number, answer will be a rational number. Same is true for the denominator. So in the numerator, we have a rational number. In denominator, we have a rational number. As a result, division of two rational number is always a rational number. Everyone knows that obviously it cannot be a rational number. Because see, if A, B, C are rational, and if we add them, subtract them, multiply them, divide them, output will always be a rational number only. This is confirmed. Okay. These are the basic properties. So what we observe, we have got two roots. One is 1, other one is beta. Beta is a rational number, and 1 can be treated as a rational number. Why? 1 can be written as 1 upon 1. So both the roots are rational. Both the roots are rational. This is for question number 13. A will be the answer. Both roots are rational. It is a good question. Okay, from 16 to 22. Question number 16 to question number 22. Any doubt?
So 16.
So this question is like similar to the one, I think first one only, because nature of roots of one equation is given and they are asking the nature of root of other equation. So here in this equation, roots are real. This is given. Roots are real means d greater than or equal to 0. So b square minus 4ac. So 1 minus 4ab is greater than or equal to 0. Now you have to discuss the nature of the other equation. Now other equation is x square minus 4 times root abx plus 1 is equal to 0. So we have to discuss its nature. We'll find its discriminant. B square minus 4ac. So this becomes 16ab minus 4. Okay. 16ab minus 4. Usually we take 4 common. Right. We take 4 common. But take minus 4 common. If you will take minus 4 common, then you will come to know the reason why I am taking minus 4 common. Because see, the value in the bracket, its sign is already known to us. Its sign is already known to us. What type of number is this? This number is positive or 0. But ultimately, it has to be multiplied by minus 4. So if it is 0, the whole product is 0. And if it is positive, the whole product is negative. So that is why the discriminant of this one is less than or equal to 0. Okay, less than or equal to 0. So if you look at the options, D is coming negative also, right? D is coming negative, so imaginary will be the answer. Imaginary, okay. Because ultimately this positive value is multiplied by minus 4. So negative into positive is negative. Discriminant negative, roots imaginary. Any other question till 22?
So
20th. Roots of both equations. Which one?
The 18th.
18th is class example. Please save your time also. Because see, this question was taken when I was teaching you that sum of if the sum of coefficients is 1, if sum of coefficient is 0, then 1 root is 1. So it is there in the notes also. They will come in AP, this class example. Question 20. Roots of both the equations. So one equation px square plus 2qx plus r equals 0. And the other equation is 2x square minus 2 root of pr x plus q equal to 0. Okay. These are the two equations. And in the question, it is given that both the equations have real roots. So just put d greater than or equal to 0 in both of them. So this will be 4q square minus 4pr greater than or equal to 0. Q square minus pr greater than or equal to 0. Q square greater than or equal to pr. Both equations must have real roots. This is given in the question, okay? Then this one, this is b. So b square minus 4ac greater than or equal to 0. 4pr minus 4q square greater than or equal to 0. Divide by 4, no sign change. Okay. But now I will multiply both sides by minus 1. This time sign will change. And as a result, q square is less than or equal to pr. If we try to combine these two, because see, both the conditions must be true. Both the conditions means first equation should have real roots. Second equation should also have real roots. So we are getting these two conditions. So it is very easy to understand that the common condition which will be satisfying both of them will be equality sign. Why? Because see, if q square is greater than pr, if q square is greater than pr, then it cannot be less than pr at the same time. But they are saying that both the conditions are valid. So then only possibility is that in first also q square is coming pr, equal to pr. In second one also q square is equal to pr. So that is why we will take the common condition for which both of them are true. That is why only equality sign will hold, or q square will come out to be equal to pr. Explanation for question number 20. Now, I think C will be the answer because they have like modified this option. C is what? P by Q is equal to Q by R, right? You cross multiply it, you will get this equation only. Q square equals P. So that is just a minor change. This is for question number 20.
So question number 19.
19, roots are real. D greater than equal to 0. Are you not able to use the conditions? These are basic conditions of discriminant. What is the problem? In all the questions, either D is greater than 0 or less than 0. So what is the problem? Where you are finding difficulty? Roots are real, D greater than equal to 0. B square minus 4AC. Minus into minus will become plus. 4 times of log a base 2 is greater than or equal to minus 16. Log a base 2 is greater than or equal to minus 2. A is greater than or equal to 2 to the power minus 2. A is greater than or equal to 1 by 2 square. See, straightforward answers are there. Where is the problem? A is the answer. At least try to use the condition and write the results. So this is for question number 19.
It's minus 4.
Minus 4? What?
The log base 2a.
Okay, wait a minute. Yeah, right. So when I will divide both sides by 4, I will get minus 4 here. Okay. So this will be minus 4. This will be, and this will be 1 upon 2 to the power 4. So it will be 1 by 16 actually. 2 to the power 4, this is 1 by 16. So which option? C will be the answer. Okay. We have to divide both sides by 4. So it will be 4 and not 2 on the right hand side. Yeah, this is correct. Thank you. Now from question number 30. Questions based on alpha plus beta, alpha into beta, like that. Which one?
The 26.
Identities 23. Must be used. Which one? Which other question except 26? Any other question?
23, sir.
23. All right. Difference of the roots of the equation is 3. All right. See, this is the equation. A minus 2x square. A minus 4x minus 2 equal to 0. Okay. So let the roots are alpha and beta. Now they are saying that the difference of the roots of the equation is 3. See, one thing that you don't know is which root is greater, alpha or beta. Because both of them are unknown to you. So either alpha minus beta will be 3 or beta minus alpha will be 3, right? Because you don't know which root is greater. Either you assume let alpha be greater than beta. Or if you don't want to assume, then also it is fine. So either you can write this or you can write this, because ultimately you will square it. And because of squaring, you will get the same result only. Now both are same. Because either you write a minus b whole square or you write b minus a whole square, you should know that it is same thing only. So now I will write only one equation. So from here, I will use the identity that a minus b whole square is a plus b whole square minus 4ab. And why I am writing it like this? Because only then I will be able to use sum of roots and product of roots. So what is alpha plus beta? Alpha plus beta is minus b by a. Minus b by a. And alpha into beta is c by a. Okay. Now we'll substitute these values here. So in place of alpha plus beta, I'll put this expression, which is a minus 4 upon a minus 2. Square is there. Minus 4 times alpha beta, which is minus 2 upon a minus 2 equals 9. Now, what is left is simplification. Taking LCM, cross multiplying, shifting the terms, okay? We do all these things. So I will just write all of them in a single step. 8 times a minus 2 is 9 times a minus 2 whole square. After taking LCM and cross multiplying, now we will have to expand this thing, okay? So a square minus 8a plus 16. 8 times of a minus 16. Right hand side, 9 times a square minus 4a plus 4. So terms are getting cancelled. Here we have a square. This is 9a square minus 36a plus 36. Calculation wise it is getting lengthy, otherwise question is straightforward because we know what we have to do in the question, okay? So we will divide both sides by 4. Divide both sides by 4. Okay. And finally we'll make the factors minus 3a minus 6a plus 9. So taking a common, just 2a minus 3 minus 2, minus 3 common, 2a minus 3. So a is coming out to be equal to 3 by 2 and 3, okay? A is coming out to be equal to 3 by 2 and 3, and that is present in A option. So in the question it was given that the difference of the roots is 3. So what I said, I don't know which root is greater. So if like alpha is greater, then alpha minus beta is 3. If beta is greater, then beta minus alpha is 3. But when I will square this equation, okay, any of the equation, I will ultimately get the same result. Because a minus b whole square or b minus a whole square is same. And why I did this squaring? Because I will use this identity that a minus b whole square is a plus b whole square minus 4ab. And then only I'll be able to use the results, sum of roots and product of roots. After putting these values, now nothing is left. However, the calculation is getting lengthy, but we can't do it anything. We can't do anything. If you want to like save these steps, then at that time you may check the option. You can put the values of A given in the options here, and you can see that for what values of A you are getting LHS equal to RHS. Okay. If you want to save the time in the test, otherwise this is the subjective approach. So this is your question number 23.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
So in this question, could you have taken mod of alpha minus beta is equal to 3?
Yeah, so that is same. That is same. Ultimately, if you will remove mod, what you will say, alpha minus beta equal to plus minus 3. That is what I have written.
Okay, sir. Yeah.
All right. Okay, so now question number 26. Question number 26 equation is px square plus qx minus r equals 0. Roots are alpha and beta, okay? And so we'll write the result, sum of roots and product of roots. See, this question can be solved. Why? Because you are asked, they are asking us to find this value, and it can be easily calculated using LCM. So I'll not solve the whole part. I will just tell you what to do. So first you will take the LCM. So it will be alpha q plus beta q upon beta square alpha square. Now in the numerator, a q plus b cube is there. A q plus b cube can be written as a plus b whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b. This is identity. Okay. In the denominator, we have alpha beta whole square. Now nothing is left in the question. Why? Alpha plus beta is known to us. We'll put this value here. Okay. Alpha beta is known. We'll put the value here. Question is over. Just simplify and get the answer. So I think now you'll be able to do it. Rest is matching the option, okay? Just put these values, you will get the answer.
Sir, can you please do the 25th one?
25th. So in 25th question, you should not cube both of them, right? Otherwise, it will become very complicated. Roots are alpha and beta. And as a result, alpha plus beta is 35 by 2. Alpha beta is c by a, that is 1. And you are supposed to find the value of 2 alpha minus 35 cube. See, if anyone is like asking their doubts in the post section, please speak and ask me here. I am not looking at your comments right now, okay? So you will think I am not solving your doubts. You can ask them here. I'm repeating again and again. So we have to find this thing, right? Now do not cube both of them. Instead, use this thing that a cube b cube means a b whole cube. So what we'll do, we will first multiply them and after that we will write the bracket. After that we will do the cube like this, okay? And what it will become, this is 4 alpha beta minus 70 alpha minus 70 beta plus 35 into 35. Do not square. Let us write it like this only. Now let us put the value. So alpha beta is 1. Alpha beta is 1, so this is 4, right? Take minus 70 common. Take minus 70 common, so alpha plus beta will remain. You will get the answer 64. Why? Because now you will put value of alpha plus beta also, which is 35 by 2. This is already 35 into 35. Okay, this will be cancelled how many times? 35 times. So what is remaining? 4 cube, 64. Why? Because minus 35 into 35 and plus 35 into 35 will cancel each other. Only 4 will remain. 4 cube is 64. So C is the answer. Okay. Do not.
So I read it another way.
No issues. Ultimately, you should get the answer and you should see how many steps you actually used. If like few steps were used, then it is fine. But if it is going too lengthy, then you can go for this. Otherwise, there can be more than one method. That is not a problem. Like what we can do, we can like use the value of 2 alpha minus 35 from here only. We can shift 2 to the left hand side. So 2 alpha plus 2 beta is 35. So 2 alpha minus 35 will become minus 2 beta. It can be solved like that also.
So I shifted the quadratic equation minus 2. So 2 equals.
It is okay, no problem. There can be more than one method. No problem. But if it is going too lengthy, then obviously we will have to look for a better method. If it is coming in fewer steps than mine, then it is better, obviously. Okay.
Question 24.
24th, yeah. Question number 24. Alpha, beta are roots of the equation. First equation has roots alpha, beta. Okay. And second equation, x squared plus
me, sir?
Yes.
So in the before question, I didn't understand how you got that last step, 4 cube is equal to 64.
See, because I have just substituted the values. What is the problem? Alpha, beta is how much? Alpha, beta is 1. Okay, alpha, beta is 1. And after taking minus 70 common, I'm writing alpha plus beta. What is alpha plus beta? It is sum of root 35 by 2. So I have substituted the value here, 35 by 2. Now this 2 will be cancelled by 70, 35 times. So these two terms will cancel each other. This is minus 35.
Okay, sir, got it, sir. Thank you, sir.
All right. Let us solve question number 24. This equation, x square plus px minus q equal to 0. This has roots alpha, beta. Second equation has roots gamma, delta. Okay. And we have to find value of the expression alpha minus gamma into alpha minus delta. Okay, let us try to simplify this and then we will see that what we are supposed to use. Let us multiply. So this is alpha square minus alpha into delta minus gamma into alpha plus gamma into delta. Okay. This can be rewritten as, like this. Okay. Try to substitute any result if you know from these two equations. And yes, we know the result. write it as R actually, otherwise it will create confusion. See, because I am drawing, I am writing R and gamma in the same way, no? So that may create confusion. That is, I am changing, I am writing R like this, okay? Now gamma and delta are the roots, so gamma plus delta, sum of roots minus P, product of roots R. Why I have calculated these two, I am going to put them here. So this is alpha square minus alpha into gamma plus delta is minus P, gamma delta is R. So till now, we have come to this point. Alpha square plus P alpha plus R. This one, our question is now reduced to this expression. But if we look the options, if we have a look at the option, we can see that answers are coming in terms of P, Q, R, any two of P, Q and R. But here alpha is also coming. That also square. This expression is coming, but this is not required. Answer is something else. In answer, we are not observing alpha in any of the option, but here alpha is coming. That also with a square. So after looking at the equation, can any one of you tell me what to do next? Just one step away from the answer. But what is that step? Can anyone observe and tell me? What is that step that I'm supposed to use? I've told you everything. We are stuck at this step. Alpha square plus P alpha plus R. Alpha is coming in our answer.
So shift.
Where?
So X square. So is it Q plus R?
But I don't know how to proceed. Tell me the step.
So the quadratic equation. So X square plus PX equals Q.
Okay. Then?
So then substitute Q.
So then it will be X and alpha and P and Q and R. So how to get rid of X?
So X you can substitute with alpha.
Yes, correct. Good. So basically alpha is root of this equation. Alpha is root of this equation, right?
But it takes time. Green, it takes time to come on.
Please keep yourself muted. Alpha is the root of this equation. Alpha is the root of this equation. Okay. Alpha is the root of this equation. So it will satisfy this equation. And as a result, alpha square plus P alpha will come out to be equal to Q, right? This thing. And here in our question, we can see the same expression here. Alpha square plus P alpha. And now, since alpha is the root, so what is the meaning of the root? That root will satisfy its equation. So in place of X, we can put alpha, okay? So as we put alpha, we get this result. And then we can shift Q to the right hand side. And we can place this value here. So answer will come out to be Q plus R. So someone can ask, sir, when to use this result that alpha is the root? Because see, in the second equation, I am using sum of roots and product of roots. But in the first equation, I have not used alpha plus beta and alpha into beta. Okay, I am not using these two results, that alpha plus beta is minus P and alpha beta is minus Q. So you can ask, sir, why we are not using this? Because in solving our question, at there is not a single step where alpha plus beta and alpha into beta are occurring. In fact, gamma plus delta and gamma delta were there, so I substituted the values. Now what we observe, alpha plus beta and alpha into beta is not coming. In fact, alpha square is coming. Okay, alpha square. So remember, whenever you find an expression in a root where a square is present, like alpha square, beta square, gamma square, such thing is present in the question. So what you will use? You will put that root in the equation, okay? And you will make an expression like this. And depending on the question, you will use the value. So square thing can help you to remember that you have to put the root in the equation and it will satisfy it, which is the condition, which is the definition of the root, okay? It's like this. It is a good question. Okay, just a minute. Yes, so this question is over.
Sir, there is some disturbance.
Should not be from my side. Wait a minute.
Okay, sir.
Is it still there?
No, sir. No, it stopped.
All right. So, yes. Now, till question number 37. Till question number 37, any doubt?
So question number 35.
Okay.
So question 37.
36.
So also
36. Okay. All right. Please keep yourself muted. Let me solve it. So let us solve question number 35. In this, actually, we will have to first change the equation in standard form. P times of x square plus n square pnx plus q n square x square equals 0. Roots are alpha and beta. So before using any result, you should observe that this equation is not in the standard form, right? So first of all, you should multiply and try to write the similar terms together. So first and last will be combined. Why? Because both of them are terms of x square. Then pnx will appear. After that, pn square will come. And now, this is alpha beta, right? So alpha plus beta is how much now? Alpha plus beta is minus b by a. And alpha beta? Alpha beta is c by a. Now what is the question? The question, they want us to find the value of p times alpha square plus beta square plus p alpha beta plus q alpha square beta square. So now nothing is left, just substitute the values. For this, I can use the identity p times alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 alpha beta. This is identity. And this is alpha beta whole square, right? So here you will put the values of alpha beta. In fact, you will put this value here also. And in this expression, you will put alpha plus beta. Question is over. Just square and simplify and solve it. You will get the answer. Is it clear? Question number 35. Change it in the standard form. Okay. Use the results, sum of roots and product of roots. And change this expression. So first one is a alpha square plus beta square. So it will become alpha plus beta square minus 2 alpha beta. So ultimately, we change every term in terms of sum of roots and product of roots. Okay. So we can use their values. This is the concept behind every question. In question number 36, this is also simple. You could have multiplied it. You will get the answer. Ax square minus bx plus c equal to 0. Roots are alpha and beta. Same thing. Sum of roots, but be careful. Sum of roots. Alpha plus beta is minus b by a. B itself is negative, so it will be minus b by a. Okay. Because this is working as b and it itself is negative. So overall, it will become b by a. Alpha beta c by a. Now we have to find the value of this expression. So obviously, we'll have to multiply it first. This will become alpha plus beta plus 1. Substitute the values. Alpha beta is c by a, alpha plus beta is b by a. Take the LCM, will get the answer. So these type of questions we used to solve in class 10th also. Sum of roots, product of roots, not a big deal. You just have to be careful while writing the results. Then 37, this is like similar to the one discussed. Was the, I think, first question of this topic. Difference of the roots is 1. So either I can write alpha minus beta as 1 or beta minus alpha as 1. Okay. So I will square it. This we already discussed a few moments back. So squaring alpha minus beta whole square will be 1. Use the identity, put the values, you'll get the answer. This is the identity. And what is given in 37 question? This is the equation. So I assume that roots are alpha beta. So alpha plus beta will be P and alpha beta will be Q. Okay. So we'll put these values here. This will become P square minus 4Q equals 1. Okay. So P square is coming out to be equal to 4Q plus 1. However, this is not what is asked. In the question, they are asking us to simplify this expression. And if you look at the options, all the options are in terms of Q. So what you have to do? Just substitute this value here. Question is over. It will be C option. Why? Because this is going to be a perfect square. 2Q plus 1 whole square. Or 1 plus 2Q whole square. Which is, I think, C option. Question number 37, C is the answer.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
So how you got 4Q square?
4Q square?
Yeah.
No, actually, no. Just go through the question first. In question number 37, what is asked? They are asking us to find the value of P square plus 4Q square. So 4Q square is already present, right? And this expression P square is equal to 4Q plus 1. This we have obtained by using the given condition. After that, I have substituted the value here. So this whole expression is now changed to this. And why we are doing so? Because all the options are in terms of Q only. So we do not need a term of P. So we are putting its value in our question. Okay. Any other doubt?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
All right. Okay, now till question number, let us finish this heading. Till 46. Till question number 46.
So 43, 44.
Okay. See question number 43. All right. Let us solve 43 first. Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Roots are alpha and beta. We have to then once again use the result. Alpha plus beta is minus b by e. Alpha beta is c by e. We have to find value of this expression now. This is question. Okay. We have to find this value. So we will have to take LCM. After taking LCM, this will be the numerator. Denominator will be A alpha plus B into A beta plus B. Now we will have to rearrange and simplify this part. So in the numerator, A beta and A alpha will be written together. We will take A common. Alpha plus beta will become. And B plus B will be 2B. So what we are doing, we are trying to create these terms. Now in the denominator, we have A square alpha beta. We are multiplying AB alpha, AB beta and B square. So this is A times of alpha plus beta plus 2B, A square alpha beta plus 2, sorry, this is take AB common, alpha plus beta plus B square. Question is over, substitute these values. With A you will get minus B by A plus 2B, A square alpha beta C by A, AB alpha plus beta is minus B by A plus B square. So in the numerator, A will be cancelled. Minus B plus 2B will be B. This will be cancelled. This will be cancelled. This is AC minus B square plus B square. So this will be cancelled in the next step and the answer will be B by AC, which is B option. So just take the LCM and try to create alpha plus beta and alpha into beta, okay? Nothing. Okay, question number 44. Question number 44. It is given that the roots of the two equations are reciprocals of each other. It is given that roots of this equation and this are reciprocal of the roots of the other. That means, let me tell you what is the meaning. Suppose that roots of these equations, first equation is alpha, R alpha and beta. Then this means the second equation will have roots 1 by alpha and 1 by beta, because this is what is given in the question. Read the question once again. If roots of the equation this and this are reciprocals of the roots of the other, that means roots of one equation are reciprocal of roots of the other equation. This is given in the question. On the basis of that, you have to find the value of A and B. Again, sum of roots, product of roots. Alpha plus beta is how much? 3 by 2. Alpha beta is 5 by 2. Now let us find the sum of roots. Use the sum of roots and product of roots here also. Sum of roots. Here the roots are 1 by alpha and 1 by beta. So they are acting as alpha and beta. So sum of roots is minus B by A. And product of roots is C by A. Okay. So overall it is a simple question, because first of all we'll get the value of A from here. Put the value of alpha beta obtained from first equation. So 2 by 5 is 2 by A. So obviously 2 will cancel each other and this will be transposed. A will be 5, right? A will be 5. And now let us simplify this. So we'll take the LCM. Now put all the values that you have calculated. Alpha plus beta, we know this value 3 by 2. Alpha beta, we have this value 5 by 2. In fact, we have A also now. A is 5. Okay. You'll get B from here. So 3 by 5. This will be cancelled. B is coming out to be minus 3. So you have to write this answer in the form of A comma B. A comma B means 5 comma minus 3. This is the answer. So C will be the answer. Okay. So there's the meaning. Both the equations have roots reciprocal of each other. So if one equation has root alpha beta, other equation will have 1 by alpha and 1 by beta as the roots. Okay. Then use the same thing, sum of root, product of root, that theory only. Okay. So I'll be solving the last one, 46. Today we will have discussion till this question only. Okay. I have given the homework till question number 69. So those who have not completed can do the remaining homework. You have one more day. I mean, now the class will be on Sunday. So you have few more days to finish the backlog. Okay, from 47 to 69. These will be discussed on the next one. Let me solve question number 46 now. So ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. I think I have solved this type of question in the class. What is given? One root of equation is square of the other. Can anyone suggest what will be the roots? What can be the roots of this equation if one root is square of other?
Alpha and square. Alpha square.
Yes, good. Alpha and alpha square. Okay. Now use same thing. Sum of roots alpha plus beta and alpha into beta. So alpha cube is c by a. Okay. Now if you look at the option, you can see that all the In fact, the question and the options are in terms of A, B and C only. That means alpha is not required. So what you will do, you will cube this equation. Why cube? Why not square or something else? Because we have the value of alpha cube, that's why. So cubing both sides. This will be minus B cube by A cube. Let's cube the left hand side. A plus B whole cube identity. A cube plus B cube. See, alpha square cube is 6. People write alpha to the power 8. Okay. Use exponents properly. A cube plus B cube plus 3AB into A plus B. This is the identity. And if you will observe carefully, you have all the values here which are required to remove alpha from the equation. Like alpha cube, value is C by A. So what about alpha 6? C square upon A square, because it will be square of cube. What about this? This underlined part. This is nothing but alpha cube. Alpha cube is C by A. And what about this part? It is also present. See here. It is present here. What is this value? Minus B by A. See how you have eliminated alpha from here and everything is in terms of A, B and C. What's left is LCM. You'll get the answer. If you don't want to CAD board and take the LCM in a conventional way, you can be a good observer and you can get the answer in a single step. Instead of LCM, multiply everything by A cube. Multiply everything means both sides by A cube, because this is the highest denominator. So if you will multiply every term by A cube, you will get the answer in a single line. But for that, you should have the idea that what exactly you are doing. A is present, A square is present, and A cube is present. So if you will multiply both sides by A cube, all the denominators will be removed in a single step. Okay. And after that, you can bring B cube to the left hand side. And you can shift minus 3ABC to the right hand side. This is the question. This is the answer. B cube plus A square C plus AC square equals 3ABC, which is option A. This is it. Okay. So question number 40 and 46 are similar. Question number 40 and 46 are similar. Exactly same theory is used. I have taken such example in class also. It is a very common question. One root is square of other. You can also go through that example. Okay. And 40 and 46 are same. So this is our discussion for today. Okay. In the next class also, we will first carry on with the discussion. And then I will teach you something new. Okay. All right. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, sir.
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 Thank you, sir.